Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be flipping through the February issue of Artists and Illustrators. I'm using the Readly app. If you're interested in checking out the Readly app, which has thousands of magazines for all different topics, then please use the link in my description where you can get 30 days to try it out. So let's get started and see what we have in the February issue. So let's go flip past those. Book of the month, Picasso, the self-portraits. The diary, open calls for prizes and artist opportunities. So that's all in January. It's funny how they've put January, but this is like the February issue. Wildlife Artist of the Year 2023. Are you the next DSWF Wildlife Artist of the Year? So there's a competition there to be entered. Exhibitions, the best art shows to visit from January onwards. So yeah, there's quite a few exhibitions throughout the year actually. So you could probably check out online to see what exhibitions there are for this year and then make a plan to go and see some. That's nice, that's pretty. That's an ad. We present Peter Bashford, an acrylic abstract artist who aims to create the feel of a place and the emotion it arouses. Some abstract artwork there. So if we change the view, you'll probably see that painting, full painting, there we go. And then that's the full paintings for those. Ollie Tuck. This still life artist finds the beauty in everyday items, painting oil from her quaint cottage studio in Surrey. This is nice. That's some of her artwork there. I always say that I'm not trying to change the world, I'm trying to decorate it. That's a nice little quote. Cornish crab in oil. They're quite nice paintings. How I Make It Work. Simona Constantine, a portrait artist who paints women to depict the purest form of emotion and uses social media in her favour. I like this painting here. Love that. Cinderella acrylic. Love that. It's like a gothic. It's got like a gothic feel to it. A gothic version of Cinderella. Simona's tips on how to make it as a full-time artist. Number one, be brave and take the first step into the unknown. Number two, practice, practice. Number three, start with the ending in mind, but don't forget to enjoy the journey. Some good old tips there. This one's nice as well. Oh, look at that. Love that painting of the dog. Henry. D.D. Gold. An Irish artist living in London, animal painter, D.D. Gold meticulously planned her career in art. Now she's written a book about what she's learned along the way, which will be an invaluable tome for those who also wish to take the leap. This book is retrospectively a compiled roadmap for others on this path. Oh, I love that. Yeah, I do like her dog paintings. Look, that's so cute. Just have a look at those dog paintings properly. There we go. There's one there. Thelma. That's cute. Habib Hajali, hopefully I've pronounced that right, ballpoint artist. Habib Hajali's practice is informed by his Sierra Leonean and Lebanese heritage in the representation of figures that have been left out of British portraiture. That's just a big interview. Mami Yoko, ballpoint pen and coloured felt tip pens. Wow, that works amazing. Look at the detail of the hands and everything, and the cloves. Very nice. This is good. Some amazing work. Look how big that is. We are proud to be the media partner of the London Art Fair. To celebrate, we look at the top curated sections of January's 35th show, London Art Fair. Okay, I wonder what dates that is. Probably in the beginning, actually, if I check that out. Francis Bacon. That's cute. That's nice. Even though that's odd. Let's see the whole painting. Oops. Change the view. Sun Worshipper. That's one of Turner's. Oh wow, I love that. Zoom in closer. Oops, what am I doing? Excuse me. This painting I love of Turner's. That's amazing. Look at that. I do love his work. He's one of my favourites. Look at that. The detail's just amazing. Light dominates and infiltrates these pictures. They bask in its glow. They sure do. British Art Prize. Chin Chin. A private view of this year's British Art Prize at Gallery OXO. Was a runaway success, not least because of the standout quality of the winning artwork. Here's a sneak peek. Grand Designs. Restoration, not sure what all that's about. Wooded landscape. Zooming in on those restoration paintings. Under the Sea. Susan Clare shows how she painted this underwater reef scene in acrylic to raise money for charities supporting the health of the world's oceans. Step by step. Let's have a look at this properly. Wow. So that's her step by step laid out there. Creating expressive animals in ink. There are many different tools to use for mark making, says Lancelot Richardson, who for this animal ink tutorial uses feathers, twigs, bamboo cane and chalk and wax resist. The red squirrel, tiger, flying fish and a polar bear. So those, if you haven't watched one of my flip throughs before, so Readly allows you to save pages. So this arrow coming out of the box here, so say if you wanted to follow this step-by-step tutorial, you could save it. It says choose which page to share, but you're not sharing it, you're saving it. You could share it though. So say everyone to do the right page. Then you can just save the image to your device and then get back to it later if you wanted to practice and follow the step-by-step. Colour, a visual history. Let's just swap views. From the Impressionists through to abstract artists of the modern day, A.L. Guri investigates a fascinating story of colour as told through the works of the master and author himself. John Constable, some other artists' work there. Obviously, Vincent's work, we all love. Cypresses, Claude Monet, Al Guri, some nice work there. So basically, there's just a little section on what about the paintings that we've just looked at. So, and what colours were used in the paintings, which I think is a useful information to study and to look at. Suffolk Trees. All of Anne-Marie Butlin's work is essentially an attempt to make beautiful, uplifting images. Here she paints serene pine trees against a backdrop of wide open space. Anne's materials. Preparing the support and applying the ground, mapping out the composition, adding the darkest tones. Let's get a full view of the tutorial. So that's letters. I think that's it. That is it, my friends. So thank you for watching this video. Please make sure that you are subscribed so that you can catch my weekly videos, and I will be back next week with another video. So take care for now. Bye for now. Bye.